Okay. So this is Pasius questions. PC015, as you can see. And then questions number 23 of page 21 over page 21. Tapi kalau ikut muka surat dia ada page 19. Okay. Tapi saya bagi, I only give you from page 1 until page 34, right? Because the rest of the questions is non-related lah, okay? Non-related. So I only give you until page 34. So we have already done. We discuss this backwards from page 34. Okay, from page 34 backwards. Now we are on page 19. Okay, number 23. So this is 045. Okay. DC 045, this is the fourth semester of program 2 tahun, program 2 tahun, PDT. In those days, we call this PDT, now we call this SES, System 4 Semester. Alright, kalau masa PDT ini, dia tidak akan jadi PST. Yang sebelum-sebelum ini, kumpulan kamu tuh kekal sampai semester keempat, sama saja, dia tidak akan bercampur dengan PST lah, dia tidak akan mix dengan PST, dan kamu ada kamu punya syllabus sendiri lah, okay? Syllabus kamu sendiri. But nowadays they already change that, so you have 1 year for SES and then you mix with SDS, System 2 semester, so they are going to be separated lah, okay, and then some of you will be together, some of you will be separated. I am going to mix with your junior, okay, SDS System 2 semester. All right, let's answer the questions. Draw a flowchart for a program that reads two numbers and display the number read in decreasing order. Okay, decreasing order means from the biggest to the lowest. All right. So you are asked to draw a flowchart. So these two numbers are your input, and then don't forget to display the number backwards. All right, backwards in reverse order. All right. Okay, so this selection, okay, the control structure for these questions is selection, if, else, okay, else if, and so on and so forth. Dalam selection, we have three parts. We have the if, the single, okay, recap, the dual, if, and else. This is dual, and the multiple, if, else, if. So you have three parts. This is dual, and this is multiple. Okay. As well as the repetition. The repetition also has, the repetition has two parts. Okay, we have the counter control and the sentinel control structure. But this part is the selection. All right, so as usual, we are going to start with the start symbol. We call this symbol as capsule. And then you're going to reach two numbers. So input, you can put any variable for the two numbers, any variables of the two numbers. For example, you can put A O B. Okay, boleh. Okay. O, you can also put, as long as it is a variable, it is okay. Num 1, num 2. Okay. So I put a selection of, I put underscore here, okay, to separate the num 1, the num, and the number. All right. Okay, so I put num 1 and num 2. So this is my variable. I choose this kind of variable. You can put any variable you like, as long as the variable is valid. All right. Don't forget the symbol is parallelogram, input and output. The symbol is parallelogram. And then the flow line, don't forget. All right, now we want to know which one is the biggest and which one is the lowest, all right? Because we want to display the numbers. Okay, we want to display in decreasing order from the biggest to the lowest. So we need to know which one is the biggest. All right, so if num1 is greater than num2, okay, so this is going to be a diamond shape. Okay, so I put the dot there for my guideline so that I can connect between two dots. All right, and then don't forget the flow line. If this is true, if num1, okay, if num1 is true, so I put here, I put to the left. Usually I put to the right, but this time I put to the left. Okay, it's your flowchart, so you can put in any direction, the left or the right or the bottom. All right, so if num1 is bigger, so we are going to display in decreasing order. So how to display? So that means num1 is bigger. So display num1 lah. First, you are going to display num1, right? So I'm going to separate this num1 with num2, which means that we are going to display the first num1. And then secondly, display num2. Okay, num2. Right. Right. So if they are false, false means num1 is smaller than num2. So if these are false, it means that num2 is larger. So we are going to display first num2, okay, num2, the second number, and then we are going to display num1, right? Okay. And then is there any else? Nothing. All right. So this is going to converge. And then stop. Stop program. So these are the flowchart. So I do the flowchart the selection, the diamond here. Okay. All right. So this kind of flowchart, the true is to the right, to the left, and the false is to the right. So it's your flowchart. You can design your own flowchart as long as it is correct. All right. You can also do the false down here. Okay. So you have 1, 2, 3 corner here. Okay. So you just pick your corner. Okay. If you want to put through is this side, so choose this side. If the false this side, and you choose that side. So it's your flowchart. So you can design it on your own. Okay. As long as it is correct. So you don't have to do the same design of the flowchart, the same flowchart design. You don't have to do the same flowchart design. You can design anywhere you want. Okay, as long as it is correct. Alright, so this is A, and then this is B. This time you need to write a pseudocode. Write a pseudocode for each of the following problem. Convert an amount of money from cent to ringgit. Alright, you are giving money in terms of cent, and then convert the cent to ringgit. We know that 1 ringgit is 100 cent. So we are going to convert. To convert the cent, we need to divide the cent by 100. Okay? To get the ringgit, we need to divide the cent by 100. Your money by 100 cents. Okay. Okay. So the code. Okay. Start. Okay. Input, and again variable, just put any variable that you think is suitable. So I put cents. Okay. Yes, input cents. It means that you are going to input your money in terms of cents. Okay. All right. And then we are going to change this cents into ringgit. So ringgit, the formula of ringgit is a cents divided by 100. Okay, because 1 ringgit is 100 cent, and you divide it with 100 and you get the ringgit lah. Okay. All right. Okay, and then display ringgit lah. So again, the symbol for division is this. If you do like this, cents, this is not recommended. Cents over cents divided by 100, not recommended. Not recommended. Not recommended. Not recommended lah, okay. Not recommended kata spelling. Alright, as well as ringgit equals to cents over 100. This one also not recommended. Also, they are correct in pseudocode, but in coding that is not correct. You cannot put that in the coding. In coding, you don't have the symbol of division in your keyboard. Okay, in your keyboard we don't have this symbol as well as this one. Okay, so the symbol that is valid is the one that is in your keyboard. Alright, done. In your keyboard, we don't have this kind of symbol, and is not suitable to write like this in fraction, in terms of fraction, cents over 100. So we can only do this in the coding, cents divide 100. This is how they do in coding. Okay. All right, so you can imagine if the formula is if the formula is very long, so in coding it is way too long. Okay, it is long also. Alright, ya, lama saya tidak cakap bahasa Inggris, huh? Saya cakaplah hari ini, walaupun tidak berapa lama saya tidak cakap Inggris. Alright. Okay, now we are going to display ringgit. Don't forget to display the ringgit. Oh, that's all. Very easier. Okay, create an amount of money from center. Okay. Convert and then stop. So the questions is quite easy. Only 4 marks. 1, 2, 3. Okay. If you have any questions, just ask or put in the comments. All right, let's go. Oh, this is very wrong. This is 12 marks. A listening test. Let's see what is the A. Oh, we already done the A. Okay, never mind. A listening test is one of the computer components in the English competency test that can be taken a maximum of 3 times only by each student. A student will have to redo the test if the marks obtained is less than 70. Oh, I remember these questions. The final mark obtained by students is calculated based on the average marks from all the listening tests taken. Based on the above scenario, create a flowchart to solve the problem. Okay. Alright, so this is quite long. This is a selection, ada if nih. We have the if because we need to know if the test is less than 70 or greater. And then we have the total. Okay. Encounter. Okay, sudah panjang ya. So apa nih, flowchart? Okay, flowchart. Alright, so flowchart mana yang boxan? Sini lah start, ha? Start. Okay. Start. We want to know the average of all the listening tests taken. The maximum listening test is 3 times. The minimum is once. Okay, only once, satu kali. So, minimum satu kali, maximum 3 kali, boleh juga 2 kali. Artinya, kalau diambil satu kali saja, so, bergantung kepada demi marka. Kalau marka dia less than 70, dia kena ambil yang kedua kali. And then kalau less lagi 70, dia kena ambil ketiga kali. And then yang ketiga kali itu tidak kisah lah. Yang ketiga kali itu tidak kisah. Sama ada di tinggi ataupun rendah, terus kita kira dia punya average, kita bahagi dengan 3. Tapi kalau yang pertama itu sudah lebih 70, 70 itulah dia punya average. Artinya 70 bahagi satu lah, itu adalah demi average. Kalau diambil dua kali saja, yang pertama less than, and then yang kedua lebih, artinya dua kali saja lah cukup. And then dua-dua itu kita campur, and then kita kena bahagi dengan 2. Okay. So kita kena pikir, kita kena ada satu, yaitu counter. So counter ini yang menentukan, counter ini yang akan kita bahagi lah. Total itu kita bahagi dengan counter. Artinya kalau diambil satu kali saja tes, dia bagi dengan counter nomor satu lah. Kalau dia ambil dua tes, counter itu dua kan. Jadi dia bagi dengan counter yang nomor dua. Kalau counter yang kalau dia ambil tiga tes, dia akan bagi dengan counter yang ketiga. So ada total di sini, yaitu total sama juga dengan kosong. Total ini adalah kita mau tambah dia punya tes, semua tes itu kita kena tambah, right? Kita kena tambah lah. Kalau tiga tu dia akan tambah lah, automatic dia akan tambah tiga. Kalau satu tu satu je lah. Kalau macam 80, yang first test itu 80 yang dia bagi dengan satu, iaitu dia punya counter yang satu. Sebab bila dia sudah 80, bila yang first test dia sudah 80, dia terus exit. Okay? Dia terus exit, dia akan kira lah total bahagi dengan counter. Alright. So we are going to set counter. We are going to set counter with 1. Don't set the counter equals to 0. Nanti susah lah. First test itu sama dengan kosong. Nanti kita akan bagi kosong pula susah. Okay. So memang tidak boleh. So we need to set the counter from 1. And then also the total. Set total equals to 0. These are the total of your listening test marks. Okay, so we are going to write this, and then okay, open your repetition. So paling tinggi pun 3 kali kan? Okay, saya cubalah. Okay. So, macam counter 1. Kita guna if else lah, rata. Macam susah pula. Okay, salah sahaja. Okay, saya ubah. Kita boleh guna repetition. Kita boleh guna repetition ni, kita guna selection. Set total, kita hanya set total kepada kosong, itu saja. And then input mark, input marks, mark 1 lah, mark 1. Alright, baru ada if, okay, baru ada if. Mark 1, if mark 1 is greater than, less than 70. If mark 1 is less than 70, okay, artinya kalau markah dia kurang daripada 70, dia kena ambil test yang kedua. Oke, dia akan ambil tes yang kedua. Jadi total berubah, total equals to total tambah mark 1. Oke. Right. And then input mark yang ke dua, input mark number 2. Oke. Okay. Input mark number 2. Right. Ini kalau true ah. This one, okay. And then if your mark 2 is still less than 70, okay, then total equals to total plus mark 2, okay, tulisan-tulisan sekitar total ni lupa channel total equals to total plus mark 2. So total yang tadi itu dia sudah berubah, dia bukan lagi kosong, awal-awal dia kosong kan, sekarang dia sudah berubah, dia sudah campur dengan markah yang pertama. And then di sini total itu dia akan berubah lagi, dia akan tambah dengan markah yang kedua sebab dia sudah ambil dua tes kan. So kita akan tambah ini kalau true. Alright. Lepas tu kita input lagi markah. Input markah yang ke 3, mark 3 lah. Okay. So after mark 3, this is the maximum test. Okay. This is the maximum test. So walaupun kita tidak tes lagi, dia rendah kah, dia tinggi kah, kita terus tambah. Total equals to total tambah mark 3. Okay. Alright. Okay. Online and then. Okay, yang ini dia ambil 3 tes kan? Jadi kita akan bahagi dengan 3. So di sini total average equals to total divided by 3. Alright, kita tengok yang false ah. Ini kalau yang true. Okay, yang ini yang pertama nih. Okay, yang pertama ya. Kalau dia false, saya tak sini false. Artinya markah dia lebih daripada 70. Jadi satu kali saja dia kena ambil test. Jadi terus kita bahagilah. So terus kita dapat demi average. Average dia adalah mark 1 lah. Ya. Yeah. Mark 1. Nah, tidak perlu lagi kita bahagi apa-apa. Memang kita akan bahagi dengan 1. Markah itu kita bahagi dengan 1 ataupun total itu kita bahagi dengan 1 sebab satu kali saja dia ambil tes. Jadi boleh tetap macam ni. Tidak ada masalah. Ini kalau false. Alright. Yang kedua. Yang ini kalau false. Kalau false artinya tes yang kedua dia punya markah lebih daripada 70. Artinya bila markah dia 70 dan ke atas, dia hanya ambil dua tesnya, jadi average dia kita akan bahagi dengan 2. Alright. Okay, total dulu, kita kasih total, tidak apalah kita total banyak-banyak pun tidak apa. So dia ada banyak cara sebenarnya ini. Total tambah maktul. Walaupun sama dengan yang ini, tapi tidak ada kena mengena. Yang ini dia jatuh ke sini. Ini dia ke sana. Alright. Maktul, and then baru kita kira dia punya average. Average equals to total. Oleh kerana dia ambil dua test saja, jadi kita bagi dengan 2. Alright. Habis semua. Boleh letak display di sini. Display average. Okay. Di sini pun boleh letak display, tapi kamu kena buat 3 kali. Jadi saya tidak suka buat begitu. Saya suka buat ini kalau pause. Saya suka buat macam ini ya. Saya gabung semua. Sini. Dan ini pun gabung. Dan terus dia display average di sini. Display ever range. And then barulah dia stop di sini. Okay. Stop ataupun end. Stop or end. Alright. Let's look again. Okay, sini. So sini jalanannya kita pergi guna counter. Alright, so start. Okay, total equals to 0. Input mark 1. And then if mark 1 is less than 0, if this is true, then the total is change. Okay. Total is updated from 0. We add with the first mark. Alright, so the total already changed here. And then we input the test, the second test of the mark. Okay, the mark of the second test, because the students get less than 70, so he will need to take the second test. Alright, this is the second test. And then if the students still get less than 70, okay, first update the total plus the mark 2. Okay. Total probe here, add with the second mark, and then the third listening test, and then after that, it doesn't matter. Okay, it doesn't matter what you get with your third test. You are going to add to your total, right? Total plus the third test, and then average total over 3, because the maximum number of tests you get will is 3 lah, okay, is 3, okay. And then in here, if you get greater than 70 and greater, you're going to calculate the average lah, okay. Just calculate the average equals to mark 1 divided by 1 ataupun total bahagi dengan, but we don't have to do like this, okay? Because they are the same. The average equals to mark 1 divided by 1, because only one test divided by 1. But I don't put 1 over here. Okay, I don't put, because the result will be the same. It's supposed to be like this, divided by 1, because 1 only one listening test, kan? Because students get greater than 70, but the result will be the same as this one. Okay, any number if you divide by 1, you will get back the same number. Okay, settle with that. And then if the students get less than 70, then the second test here, we will do the second test. And if we do better, if the students do better, which is greater than 70, so the total will only add with the mark 2, the second mark, or the second test, and then average total divided by 2 lah, because the students did only 2 tests, right? So the average we are going to divide by 2. All of these will be converged to here. And then you are going to display the average. This one go to here, this one go to here, and then display the average. This one go to here, and then display the average. And then you will get your average. Maklah, and then we stop the program. This is what I can think. Maybe if you have different method, you tell me. Because first I want to do the repetition, but it is very hard for me to do. You can do the repetition, but I think you don't have in your syllabus that you can end. You have three ends, okay? Three stop. Okay? If you do the repetition, you will get a three stop. Okay, three stop lah. A stop in the middle, and then stop in the second. Stop in the first, and then stop in the second, and then stop in the third. If you do the repetition, okay. But I don't want to do that, so I decided to do the selection. Also get the same results, right? Okay, because the questions doesn't stated that you should do repetition or selection. It doesn't say in the question, so you can do any control structure that is applicable, okay? That is applicable, that is correct. All right, this is number 12 marks, so it is very long. Nanti saya bagilah kalau ada jawapan lain. If I get any other answers, I will give to you if I have the time. All right, let's look number 17, already done. So it looks like we already done the previous questions. Ada sudah semua. Tengoklah apa yang okay sini. Page number 14, right? A former secretary has left her job and decided to sell textbooks. Assume the book is sold at different price on each day. Write a pseudocode to calculate how much money that will be earned after a week. Assume the book is sold at different price. Is it only one book? One kind of book? Write a pseudocode to calculate how much money that you will get. He will earn after a week. All right, so there are 7 days. Okay, repetition. Okay, repetition of 7. I assume that this book is only one kind of books, but each day the books are sold in different price. I assume lah. Okay, let's say the book is this one. Okay, the same books, but it is sold at different price each day lah. Okay, maybe. Okay, a different price on each day. So only one price for each day. So all we need to do is to input how many books the secretary sold and what is the price for the textbook, for one textbook. Okay, how many books that he sold in each day, and then the price for the books. So only one kind of books. Okay, all right. So what is throughput? Okay, so start. These are the repetition because we are going to enter 7 times. 7 times. So we need a counter and a total. Counter, you can say, you can start with 0 or 1, anything you like. Okay, because we don't you can choose any value you want. And then total is, of course, zero. We start from zero. Okay, total, how much money? Okay, total money ka apa-apa sila. Alright, start. Okay, and then we are going to set counter to 0 or 1. Okay, and then set your total usually start with 0. Okay, all right and then while we are going to repeat this 7 times. So while counter, while counter is less than 7, 0 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, so 7 not one. Okay, so paling rendah, paling tinggi pun dia akan naik 6. And then total books sold. Books are as books sold. Okay, sold lah. I put sold. Books sold. Books sold. We are going to input nah. Input books sold. Okay, I always put underscore between two words, between words, and then input price, and then we are going to total input book sold means that how many books that the secretary sold, that the secretary sell in each day, in one day, right? The total books sold, and then total means total of the price lah, okay? Or total of what the secretary earned. So book sold, this is easy maths. Book sold times the price lah, okay? Book sold times the price. Bukan total lah, not total. I put earn lah, earn. Because total we already use here, so total earn lah. I will put earn. You can put any variable lah that is suitable. And then we are going to update total, which is total plus the earn, okay? The earn, the total here, the total, the first total is zero, so zero will plus the earn here, okay? Earn. And then we are going to update counter. So counter equals to counter plus 1. Always update your counter. If you don't update your counter will remain 0. Okay? If you don't update your counter always remains 0. And if it is 0, you're going to have unlimited loop or unlimited repetition. Tidak pandai habis. Tidak pandai habis di loop sebab sentiasa kosong. Right? So you need to update your counter by 1 lah. 1 means 1 day. And then one day, and then until 6, until you get counter 6, and then until you get counter 7, and you are going to be exited. Alright, so repeat while, and then after the 7th counter, it will going to end the loop, and while. And then we are going to display auto for that 1 week. Okay, for that 1 week. So stop. Right. So itu saja. Very easy lah. This are easy. This are counter control loop. Okay, because we know how many loop in the program. Okay, in the programming. In the programs, huh? We know how many loops, which is 7 lah. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 lah toh, okay? 7 finger. Yang 7 tu, yang 8 sudah tidak boleh sudah. Tidak boleh sudah. Alright, so you can also, if your counter is equals to 1, okay? Kalau counter kamu equals to 1, then your while counter itu is less than or equals to 7, okay? Less than or equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or less than 8, okay? Less than 8 is equals to 7. Sama juga, mana-mana saja ini atau if you choose your counter to 1 lah, okay? Alright, itu saja biasa ada. Okay, betul macam ada soalan. Counter dia bukan mau ada equal juga kah saya? Mana ni? Tidak, yang ini kalau ini tidak ada equal. Ini sebenarnya paling tinggi adalah 6. Okay, kalau kamu kira dari 0 sampai 6 itu 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Jadi kalau mungkin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, ada 7 loop. Okay. Dia ada 7 loop. Kalau yang ada equal yang ini. Okay, yang bermula dari 1. Yang ini paling last. Nombor paling last adalah 7. Itu juga yang di bawah ni. Less than 8 kan? Less than 8 adalah 7. So, start dari 1. Then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 last kali. Yang 8 tidak boleh sudah masuk. So sama juga 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lah. 7 kali. So kamu ada option lah. Option sama ada letak ini. Yang ini counter kosong ataupun counter 1. Kalau 1 ada equal lah di sini. Okay. Right. Kalau kosong tidak ada. So kita bermula dari kosong. Dari kosong sini. So ini kalau kamu kira 7-7 nih, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Ini kalau bermula dari 0, 7 times. Ini kalau bermula dari 1, 7 times as well. So, up to you, okay, to decide which one you like. Either counter 1 or counter equals to 0. So, up to you. But remember, the while is also different, okay? Make sure the while is correct and don't forget to update your counter. If you don't update your counter will remain the same, okay? Kalau kamu tidak update, kalau kamu tidak tambah kamu punya counter ini kan, dia akan sentiasa kosong ataupun dia akan sentiasa satu. Jadi sentiasa masuk unlimited lah, dia tidak akan habis. Loop kamu tu tidak akan habis setiap kamu punya value itu sentiasa kosong kamu punya counter tu. Jadi kamu jangan lupa update kamu punya counter tu lah, right? Okay, next. Okay, terima kasih pada soalan. Boleh panjang. Right, so ini soalan yang last lah untuk hari ini. Okay, apa ni? The table below, okay, shows the educational level of the student based on his or her number of years of school. Draw a flowchart to display a message indicating the educational level. Year number 1 to 6, kindergarten 7 to 12, primary 13 to 18. So these are selection lah, sebab dia ada pilihan. So ini adalah selection. These are selection control structure because we have choices. We have three options, so these are definitely selection. A student only, so meaning that only one student, a student here. So only one student, so there's no repetition, there's no 2, 3, or 4 times entry, only one entry, 6 marks. Alright, okay. Jadi senang saja. So selection 1 to 6 kindergarten, 7 to 12 primary, 13 to 18 secondary. Alright, remember that. So do a flowchart. So we're going to start. Sini lah. Start. Okay. Capsule. Then input age ke? Number of years. Number of years. Input years. Alright. Input years. Okay. Alright, apa ni? So we have range from 1 until 6. Okay. Ada macam-macam cara lah, okay. Ada macam-macam cara. Alright, saya buat cara yang pertama. Okay, years less than and equals to 6. Okay. Less than and equals to 6. So these are primary, if true, display primary, okay, if false, and then yes, less than and equals to, how many? 12. If this is true, display. Eh, pertama itu kindergarten. Di kindergarten. Display kindergarten. Make sure they are obvious, huh? And then display primary. This is true. And then anybody else? Anybody else is less than. Of course, is greater than 12. So these are secondary display. Second, third. Correct. 18. Anybody else? Better. Okay. So itu lah. So. Then we stop the programming. Always stop your programming. All right. Yeah. Okay. Let's look at the flowchart. Input years. All right. So if your years is less than and equals to 6, so you are kindergarten. Else, if your years is less than 12, maybe 8, maybe 7, maybe 10, this is primary. So less than 12, walaupun 2 kan, number 2 is also number 2, is also less than 12, but it is already picked in here. Nomor 2 tu, nomor 2 sudah dipilih di sini. Jadi nomor 2 tu dia tidak akan masuk di bagian sini. Walaupun 2 itu kurang daripada 12. So yang masuk di sini adalah yang 7 dan ke atas. 7 and above. Selain daripada ini lah. 7 and above dia akan masuk di sini. Right? Until 12 lah. Okay. Until 12. 7 until 12. Dia akan masuk sini. And then it will display primary. If you get 13 years and more, 13 years and more, these are 13 years and more range, no? Okay. So automatically, this is going to display secondary. All right. So another way, there's another way to write this, but it is very confusing. We put like this. Okay, the second option. Okay. Yes, is. Yes, okay, is greater and equals to 1, and yes is less than and equals to 6. Tapi terlalu panjang loh. Eh, okay. It is quite long. Dia macam range. Dia panjang. So dia dalam range itu. Yes greater than 1 and yes less than 6. So the range is between 1 and 6. The other one is like this, like in maths, okay? Less than one to six. Ini pun boleh. But this is not recommended, huh? Because in coding, dalam coding, in terms of programming, we do not write like this, okay? We do not write the range like this. We are going to write like this. This one is also not. We are going to write like this in coding. The n 2 times. Okay. The n there is 2 times. It means that in the range of 1 and 6. Ini yang dalam coding. So ini not recommended. Because this is not the way to write in your programming. Okay, this is not the way. This is the way, and also this is the way, right? Okay, sometimes you don't have any option. We have to do like this. Sometimes we can do like this. Kadang-kadang tidak ada pilihan. Terpaksa kita buat macam ini. Okay? Terpaksa sebab susah kita tidak dapat buat yang macam gini, tapi ini boleh. Okay. So dia, ini kita panggil sebagai less than method. These are called less than method. Okay. So semua less than, ini less than, ini less than. Kadang-kadang ada banyak juga, sampai 4 kali. Okay. Bergantung kepada soalan. Alright. So you can also do like this. So you have three options, like this, and like this. Make sure all of them are less than a, dan mesti betul lah, mesti betul. Okay, kita sudah sampai di penghujung, 13 minit. Saya rasa tidak ada soalan kan? Betul. Betul tidak ada soalan? Mana suara? Hello? Betul kan tidak ada suara? Belum ada. Okay. Tidak kedengaran sudah suara kamu. Semakin pemalu. Okay. Tiada. Alright. Okay. So kalau begitu kita boleh Well, that's it for today. So I will meet you again on Wednesday to discuss more questions. Mungkin saya akan bagi lebih banyak soalan lah. Saya akan cari lebih banyak soalan. So all you have to do is just to practice lah, itu saja. Tidak susah nih. So SEM 2 ini kalau boleh lebih banyak yang dapat ya. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you very much.